On the HBO drama The Wire, Felicia Pearson commands the screen as Snoop, a female assassin for a major drug kingpin. Her character is so compelling that horror writer Stephen King called her perhaps the most terrifying female villain to ever appear in a television series. In her new book, Grace After Midnight, a memoir, the 27-year-old Baltimore native tells of a life that resembles that of one on screen. And joining us now is Felicia Snoop Pearson. Welcome to the show.
Glad to be here.
Felicia, how did it happen that you ended up being someone who was living on the street, you know, here in Baltimore, to the show, The Wire?
I met Michael K. Williams at the Club One in Baltimore. He brought me to the writers. They told me to start talking, and I went for an audition, and I got the part.
So basically, they just wanted you to be the person that you are.
Yes.
Every day.
Yes.
But you have evolved from that person.
Yes.
You are every day. And even you talk about in your book that there were a lot of people in your life who tried to keep you off of the streets.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
My uncle Arnold Lonely, that's who I made the book out to. He wanted me to go right, but I'm like, how you gonna tell me go right and you doing wrong? I wanna do what you doing. And
uncle was doing what?
He was selling drugs.
Mm-hmm.
And after his passing, when I was incarcerated, I mean, I just got my head together because he was like, you don't have life. You don't have 20 years, 15 years. Get out of here and do something with yourself. And that's the last thing he told me.
Okay, and by the time you were 10, you talk in the book that a lot of things you'd seen a lot. I mean, you were born, you talk about you were born a crack baby here in the city of Baltimore, and then living in a foster home. And by the time you were 10, you said you saw so much from the streets. Tell us about what you saw.
I seen a lot. People were hustling, killing each other. I mean, it's just a lot for a young child to see at an early age.
Mm-hmm.
And I just coped with it and just went through it. Just went through it. It's just tough being a teenager in the streets of Baltimore.
Mm-hmm. And you even talk in the book, I mean, that book is raw. You talk about the first time you witnessed some serious violence.
I was young. You witnessed
a murder.
Yeah, I was young.
But this is the kind of thing that young people growing up in Baltimore are seeing every day.
I mean, sometimes every day, yeah.
You also talk about there's the new Snoop and the old Snoop.
Mm.
Tell us about the old Snoop, because that old Snoop was a smart girl. I mean, you were always being told how smart you are. You were doing well in school.
Mm. Yes, ma'am. The old Snoop, yes, I was smart, but I also had a hard head, and a hard head make it soft behind.
Mm-hmm.
And I was, I don't say too much of cold-hearted,
mm-hmm.
but yeah, sometimes I just ain't care about nothing, mm-hmm. care about nothing.
You think that's a result of sort of being left in the world the way you were by your parents? Your mother died, father not around?
Yeah, that plays a big part of it too. You know, not knowing your real family and like kids just teasing you, talking about, hey, you adopted, or you cross-eyed, just mm-hmm. laughing at you, teasing you all the time. And that played a big part of it too. I mean, it's a lot of things play a big part of it.
So The Wire brought you great opportunity. There's a new Snoop now.
Yes.
Tell us about the new Snoop and what you're doing with your life.
Now I'm an author, actress, rapper. I'm trying to get into everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to get into, trying to put this this center together for the kids, mm-hmm. you know, because kids have too much time on their hands after school. So I'm just trying to put like a basketball team together.
Mm-hmm.
Hope that Nike sponsor.
You're going to be in some other movies?
Yeah.
Some movies? Tell us
about
movies
that. Too. I'm in one right after The Wire in January, but they asking me not to talk about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
A whole new world is opening up for you because you know, after you had to pay your dues
mm-hmm.
Behind bars, But and you tried to get jobs. People would give them to you initially, and then
they fired me because of my background. They get you ready for society and the penitentiary. And as soon as you come home, society still knock you down. Mm-hmm. So why do they teach you job readiness, get your GED for what? When they, as soon as you come home, you try to get a good job. Mm-hmm. Every job that I tried to get paid $15 an hour, mm-hmm, because I was good with my hands. Mm-hmm. And they just fired me because of my background.
We're about out of time, but before we go, I have to ask you, for those who are watching, who were thinking they got messed up on the street somehow, that it's not too late, what hope do you have to offer them? What can you tell them?
Just motivation, you know. I mean, everybody have their trials and tribulations. Just keep yourself motivated, you know, keep your head up. I mean, it's a dark tunnel, but it's always a light at the end. It's always a light. And that, and Grace After Midnight, it's a light. It's a bright light.
All right, and again, the book is Grace After Midnight, and Snoop, we will be watching for that new movie, and we'll be watching The Wire.
All right, thank you.
Thanks for coming in. Don't go away. We'll be right back. You're watching 11 TV.